Hey Leo, how are you? Welcome back to Clarity Goddess Tarot. Today we're going to be doing a general reading for your sign, okay, for January 7th through January 14th, 2019. Keep in mind, you guys, that these messages may or may not resonate for you, okay? They are here for the public on YouTube, so if you want something that's more specific for your particular situation in your life, you could definitely book a personal reading, okay? You can contact me at claritygoddesstarot@gmail.com. Also, the energies are interchangeable, so it could be you or the other person, and the cards are not gender specific, okay? So it could be a male or a female carrying the energies, okay, you guys? But yeah, I'll leave all the information in the description box, okay? I am also offering 3 free questions in the personal readings, okay? So you can ask up to 3 questions that are incorporated into your reading, or you could just get question reading, okay, which is not a full reading, it's just kind of based upon questions. I hope that makes sense to you guys, but yeah, all the info is in the description box. Let's go ahead and get started, okay? So over to the left is the past energy, here in the center is the present energy, to the right is the future. Up at the top is you, Leo. Down at the bottom is them. But like I always tell my viewers, it can be vice versa, okay, you guys, because this is a general reading. So it could be you or the other person, or, you know, just a collective of the energies, okay? So just take whatever fits for you, okay? So yeah, let's go ahead and get started. Some of you were involved in some type of cycle with someone that has not come to an end, okay? Others of you it has, but secrets came out about something that this person was doing, or maybe they found out something you were doing, okay, which caused somebody to kind of close themselves off emotionally, all right? But yes, with the Moon card in reverse and the Wheel of Fortune in reverse, yeah, so something was revealed, and it ended up being very painful for somebody else, okay? But I still feel as though this cycle has not fully ended here, okay? Maybe some of you have children with this person, and it's been hard to cut ties with them, okay? But yeah, that's for the past energy. I feel as though some of you may be in a friends with benefits type of situation, okay? Where it's like you guys have feelings for each other, but you still kind of block your emotions from each other. I don't mean to laugh, but I'm just saying, like, a lot of people are caught up in those type of situations, okay? Especially when you have kids, you know, you and this person may still sleep together, but ultimately you guys are not together, you know, officially. So that's just for some of you. But here in the current energy, we have the Five of Swords in reverse. So yeah, it's a lot of mind games going on here with this person, okay? Type of person that probably, you know, comes and pleads their case, or I'm sorry, I'll change, or I'll work my, you know, I'll work this out, or I'll, you know, do what I need to do to get us on track. And then they turn around and they do the bullshit again. You know, somebody that just cannot stick to their word, okay? For some of you, this person, they have an addiction. Even though I don't see the Devil card here, which speaks about addictions, intuitively, I'm picking that up for some of you, okay? That won't apply for everyone, but somebody here is dealing with some type of addiction, or either some type of bipolar issue, okay? It's like they want to do good and they want to change, but for whatever reason, I don't know, it might be family or friends around or some sort of addiction. I don't know, maybe the social media or attention is another thing I'm picking up that, you know, it just distracts them and they're not able to stay focused, okay? But somebody wants to avoid this tower moment. We have the Tower card in the reverse and the Death card here, okay? So, you know, and that's in the reverse too. So both of these cards kind of speak about endings, okay? Change, a transformation that needs to happen, but someone's not doing that. Someone's not allowing themselves to do that, okay? Others of you, you know, I feel as though you and this person are still in contact, but you're going to end up leaving them alone, okay? And going to find a new beginning elsewhere, because we have the Ace of Pentacles. But yeah, that does speak about new beginnings. Okay. So just to summarize this current energy, again, I feel there's mind games going on. Some of you could be caught up in a friends with benefits, type of situation where it's like there's feelings there, you know, but both people may be a little egotistical or just too prideful to admit it, okay? The situation where changes need to happen, but they're just not happening here, okay? Now, for the top energy, we have the Ace of Swords and the Page of Cups, as well as the Nine of Cups. So, yeah, I feel strongly that, you know, this person, they come through with a love offer, or, you know, pretending to be truthful with that Ace of Swords, but ultimately you end up feeling hurt or backstabbed, okay? Which could possibly be putting you in this Queen of Wands energy, okay? That is fire energy, you know, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, but you know, this is like a woman scorned, or someone that's maybe manipulative, vindictive, okay, or just mean, kind of cold. You know, this queen and the queen of swords in reverse, they kind of remind me of each other. It's just not really a pleasant energy to have, okay? But I feel if this is you, Leo, or the other person, whoever has been wronged here, that's what has created this, okay? That's what's created you reacting to this person in this way of the Queen of Wands because of the bullshit that they do. You know, their betrayal, their constant lies and backstabbing is what I'm picking up for some of you, okay? Others of you, this is them. Again, like I say, they come through and they pretend to care or love you or that you guys are going to have something solid, but they end up being back in this manipulative, narcissistic energy, okay? Now for this person down here at the bottom, again, guys, take it how it fits. Like I said, this could represent that this person misses you. Okay. With the Six of Cups here, this does speak about nostalgia, them thinking about the past a lot. Okay. Others of you, this person or either you, has a lot of burdens going on. Okay. With dealing with their past, maybe they had some issues in their childhood or something that's been affecting them in their adulthood. Someone may be drinking a lot, okay, because they have unresolved issues from their childhood, all right? Others of you, you could have children with this person, okay, which has, again, made it hard for you to completely cut this situation out, but it's heartbreaking, okay? Somebody is dealing with a lot of pain here, okay, with this Three of Swords. You know, some of you could have been in a third party situation. I mean, that doesn't apply for everyone, but nonetheless, the Three of Swords does represent pain, betrayal, heartbreak, rejection, you know, that type of energy. Someone could have got caught here as well, okay, with the Seven of Swords in reverse. This is sneaky energy, okay? Sneaky, lying, deceptive, okay? Manipulative, again. So yeah, but this person, they come forth with this Knight of Cups energy, which is a court card, okay, about, you know, wanting to start something or expressing themselves, but they're still sneaky, okay? They're still dealing with some issues, honey, and I feel for a lot of you, this has to do with their past. Some of it may have to do with the connection between you two, but somebody is carrying a lot of burdens, whether you know about it or not. Somebody's carrying a lot of burdens from their past, and I feel as though someone here may use drugs or alcohol to cope, okay? Again, that won't apply for everyone, but yeah, so this person wants to rush back in, maybe mend the situation, okay? But, you know, I personally intuitively don't believe that they're honest, okay, Leo? Now, over here in the future energy, we have the King of Wands in reverse, fire energy. Yeah, he can be, again, manipulative, just like the Queen of Wands, okay? Some of you, you guys were married, and both of you hurt each other very deeply with the things that you say and the things that you do. I feel for some of you, this is a tit-for-tat type of situation. Again, it could be friends with benefits, a lot of great sex or passion between you guys, attraction, but other than that, you guys just don't fucking get along here, okay, is what I'm picking up, all right? Somebody could also be doing some spying here, spying on this person, or they're spying on you with this lover's card. You also could be dealing with a Gemini, okay? But again, this, to me, the lover's card, it's not so much soulmate energy or a lot of deep emotions. It's mainly about sex, okay? This won't apply for everyone, but some of you have a situation that's based upon sex, okay? Great sex, but nonetheless, it's like that's all it is, okay? It's like it's nothing more here. And some of you are needing to walk away from this, okay? And you will. You will, Leo, because, or they will, because we have the Strength card. This is the card that represents the sign of Leo, okay? And justice will be had in this situation, all right? Because we also have the Justice card. You also could be dealing with a Libra, but, you know, justice is going to be had. Now, whatever that pertains to, I don't know, maybe it's child support, okay? For those of you that have children with this person, if they haven't been doing their part, okay, justice will come for that. Or justice, period. You know, you having the strength to cut ties here, okay? Because I feel like somebody is emotionally invested, and I think the other person is too a little bit, but they're just not balanced, okay? They just don't know what they want. They're all over the place. You know, they keep apologizing and doing the same shit again, you know, is what I'm picking up for some of you, okay? But yes, overall, I don't think it's a terrible reading, you know? I just think that somebody here definitely has some issues going on, okay, Leo? So, yes, thank you so much for tuning in, okay? Again, if you would like a personal reading, you can contact me at claritygoddesstarot@gmail.com. I am offering the 3 free questions incorporated into the personal readings. So all that information will be in the description box. Okay, you guys, thank you again. Don't forget to hit the like, share, and subscribe button and bell notification. I'll see you guys next week.